circuit missed a few years off the F1 calendar, and we missed Albert Park. So welcome back, and it's great to be back in Melbourne. Welcome to the Australian Grand Prix. So here we are at Albert Park Circuit, 3.28 miles around, with the streets making for a bumpy surface with little undulation. There are 14 corners around the lake, with the best passing opportunities coming at turn 1 and turn 3. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. A fantastic effort from Charles Leclerc yesterday, and it's put him on pole, and Lando Norris lines up alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Oscar Piastri, Sainz, Perez, Russell, Verstappen, Hamilton, Taylor, Liam Lawson, Gasly, Teo Pourchaire, Stroll, Albon, Tsunoda, Joe, Bottas, Magnussen, Ocon, Hülkenberg, De Vries, and Logan Sargeant. With preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going. Okay, so let's go through all the gears if we can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes. We need to keep the engine cool though, so don't go too high with the revs. Okay, radar is clear, weather is looking good for now. Okay, that's not an ideal placement in your grid slot. You're going to need a good launch at the race start. Okay, so that's the rest of the grid forming up now. Be patient and watch for those lights. battery charge is high, let's use that overtake button a bit more. Job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. We're increasing our gap on the car behind by around a second a lap. We're approaching the pit window now, and you're going to be on hards next time. Got a lot of spare energy, okay to use your overtake button. Be aware, the grip levels are going to start falling away soon. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 11.5 seconds. Fox for coming in this lap. Liam is in the pit lane. Liam's in the pits now. Here's some information on Hülkenberg. Okay, they're out of this race. We had an issue removing the left front wheel. I know it's not ideal, mate, but let's try and put it behind us and get back into this race. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. Yellow flag. Okay, clear. Here's the gap that we're trailing the car ahead by, 2.3 seconds. Leclerc's taken the lead. Nice work, mate. That brings you up a place. Gap to your teammate behind is 0.5 seconds. Okay, keep an eye on that gap ahead, please. 1.6 seconds. think you can get past, make use of the overtake button and see what you can do. Five laps of fuel remaining. Catching the car ahead, well done, but be aware, these tyres need to get us to the end of this race. Okay, you've got four laps of fuel remaining. Okay, good work. Great pass. Pulling out a second a lap on the car behind. Really good stuff. Okay, mate, final lap. Keep your concentration and let's bring it home. Okay, we've only got one lap of fuel remaining. Proud of you, man. That was a good job. You did really well out there. Superb driving.
We've witnessed some great battles on the streets of Melbourne today, then, and they've taken a fantastic win. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
I feel consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalise on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
Looking at the podium, you can see that red suit familiar to fans across the globe. A world-class win for a world-class team. Ferrari, do it again. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. Taylor increases their championship lead. Let's focus on the driver of the day. Natalie Pinkham, come on, who do you pick?
Well, my driver of the day has to be Charles Leclerc. He was unstoppable out on track today, weaving through the competition with ease.
Let's move on to the constructors. The owner driver's team moved to the top of the table. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend for them as they fight their way towards the top. Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.